Pentagon announced the new package of military aid to Ukraine in amount of $820 million. There are not so many positions in it, but all of them are very important. First, these are additional missiles for MLRS HIMARS, which have already managed to show themselves very well at the front. In the previous video we discussed the advantages of this system and its impact on the current stage of the conflict. If you haven't seen this video, just follow the link in the description. Secondly, the long-awaited air defense system NASAMS, which is used in the United States to protect White House and Capitol buildings. NASAMS stands for Norwegian Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, developed by Kongsberg Defence Aerospace and Raytheon. It is designed to provide short-to-medium range air defense against aircraft, helicopters, cruise missiles, and drones. It is reported that so far, the United States will transfer only two such systems. Most likely, we are talking about NASAMS platoon kits, each of which includes three launchers for 18 missiles, a Sentinel-3 coordinates radar station, and a fire control panel. This is the basic unit for this air defense system. As for today, there are only three generations of this air defense system. NASAMS 3, the latest version, uses a Ghost IMR radar system originally developed for the Patriot air defense system. It is a 360-degree surveillance and fire control sensor designed to detect, track, and identify a wide variety of threats, including cruise missiles and drones, fixed-wing and rotary-wing aircrafts, as well as helicopters. As stated, Ghost IMR also helps to counter sophisticated long-range mass attacks and provides increased range and altitude coverage that will expand the defended area capabilities of NASAMS. While the US has not announced which version it is providing to Ukraine, it is likely NASAMS 1 or NASAMS 2, which doesn't have such radar. The missile for the NASAMS can engage 72 targets simultaneously in active and passive modes. This can be achieved in a battalion configuration of 12 launchers and up to 72 missiles loaded. All missiles can be fired against individual targets in less than 15 seconds. The primary missile for the system is AIM-120 AMRAAM Advanced Medium Range Air-to-Air Missile. It is developed and best known as an air-launched fire-and-forget missile deployed on the F-15, F-16, F-22, Eurofighter, and other fighting aircrafts. By the way, in 2015, a Turkish Air Force F-16 shot down a Russian Su-24M strike aircraft using this missile. This occurred over northern Syria after Russian aircraft allegedly crossed into Turkish airspace. The multi-missile launchers can also fire the missile AIM-9X Sidewinder, which is able to hit targets at a range of up to 40 km and at the height of up to 14 km. Ukrainian military expert Mikhail Samus believed that this air defense system cannot completely close the sky from Russian rockets. He suggested that a complex-level multi-layer air defense should be created. NASAMS is a great short-to-medium-range system, but to clear the sky, in addition to the system, we need long-range, all-altitude MIM-104 Patriot. In this way, the deployment of the Patriot and NASAMS systems will provide the opportunity to create multi-layer defense system and use it against various types of missiles. NASAMS will not be able to close the entire territory of Ukraine, or even cover large cities. It could also take weeks or even months to train operators and the maintenance technicians who will get the hardware in working condition. According to Maxim Glushenko, head of the Anti-Crisis Initiative Center, NASAMS will definitely enhance our anti-aircraft defense of our air force that is using Soviet-era weapons. the latest of which is 30 years old, and we understand that our rocket stocks are depleting. Also, Soviet systems work manually, contrary to the Western ones that are more computerized and use AI technologies, so they depend less on the crew and more on their electronics. NASAMS with AMRAAM-ER rockets, which in theory can deal with ballistic missiles, could be used in our rocket defense, and this is the first step. We can see from other US shipments that they initially give a small test batch, assess its effectiveness, and afterwards increase volumes. Let's also not forget about the RST system promised by Germany. Many compare it with NASAMS, and not without reason. End of quote. You can protect the sky from the enemy cruise missiles not only with ground anti-aircraft systems. Aviation successfully does this job too. There are regular reports of Ukrainian jets shooting down missiles, but the number of Ukrainian aircraft has decreased since the beginning of the war, and the supply of American fighters is not yet being discussed. The system is in use in 12 countries, including the US, Finland, the Netherlands, Spain, Oman, and Chile. The cost of one NASAMS platoon is $23 million in 2022 prices. The cost of each shot, there is one AIM-120 AMRAAM missile, is more than $1.2 million. Thank you for watching.